Hi guys, Lone Wolf Outdoors. Thought I'd come out today, this afternoon, into the evening. It's such a nice day. I spent all morning doing paperwork with a new tax here. So, I brought the tap on the hammock. Last time I stopped off here, I seen a few squirrels and a few birds of prey. So I'll come out today and be a bit more stealthy today and just sit and wait and see what comes around again. So I'll stay here now until nightfall and see how it wanders through. I'm just going to set enough to get some water from a local stream, so I take you to see there. But that's where I'm set up at the moment. So just a little bit stealthy, not a lot, just enough for I don't get recognised by the by whatever's gonna pass through. I'm hoping I see a fox coming through, so that is my main goal really, see if I can get a wandering fox through. But anything else goes really. I can catch her on film. It's much different. So that's what I'll do for what I've set out to do. So we'll come back to that guys and I'll show you. But I said I'm gonna get some water now. It's a little stream. I've got my Sawyer Mini and so I'll filter it. There's been a lot of trees being pulled down around here, so so I'll be cautious about the water. Yeah, such a lovely day in South Wales today. We've got some rain coming in tomorrow, the next couple of days, and I think the weekend is going to be pretty much like this then. As you can see, there's a bit of a track. Bit of a track here. Going up there, where you can see the clearing, that was full of wood. That's where they chopped them all down. And I'm up and over there. So I'm out of the way. I just want to find a nice spot where it's trickling. That looks nice place there. As I said, they've been pulling a lot of trees down, so I'll purify this water just to be on the safe side. And then guys, I'll bring them back in a bit. So yeah guys, we are back at my little setup. farmer's dog. 300 meters away. But, I just take you under. I just gave my hammock. Stop me rocking. Hang on. So, this is my view from the top. The wind is blowing towards me, so I think I'll pick my sand up. The only way they'll spot me if I'm dancing about like a crazy man. So when the time comes, golden hour, I'll settle down. And, just lie here watching until nightfall. Go work tomorrow, so this tarp, I know this has got a few holes in it, which I need to repair. There's one there, there's one there, it's quite a big one by here, by there. To repair them on the weekend. Not a bad tarp for the price, £14 from Amazon. So can't really grumble. Got loads of hoops on it, right across. Got the poppers. Got the poppers there. Got single poppers, double poppers. Already folds into your makeshift baby bag. Just, I have used and I did hold a bit of condensation by the morning, but did the job at the end of the day. It kept me warm and it kept me dry. I'm gonna set up my cover now. I brought those wood pallets up with me to have a go with that. I did do a test the other day in the garden, but I won't do so many. I just want to work out how much I need to just to burn to have a brew and quick bite to eat. So I'll be doing that as well. This brings me back to when I was hunting with the shotguns from my father and with the air guns. Used to like the air gun hunting, quiet stuff. Used to build hides out where we can see sticks and and wood, mixture of hide and gosh, waiting there for hours and hours. Pigeons and squirrels and rabbits. Right guys, I'm gonna it's quarter past four. About 2 hours now before we start. Getting dark, so I'm gonna put a brew on. And guys, I got a stove set up. Here's my pine wood pellet cat litter. So just light it and get going. Right, I get back to it a bit. That's the waxwood chiplet. So you'll as you burn the wax and melt and get hot, trip on the pellets and ignite it that way. So probably take about 10-15 minutes from the start when it's going properly. Yeah, I'm just gonna filter this water and then I bring it back when he's up and firing. Right guys, while that's catching away there, as you can see, it's gone black. It'll spread right round. All that, while that's doing. Take you around the hammock. Beautiful day. The only thing I don't like about these, let me walk down there and I'll show you. The only thing I don't like about these tarps, they glare a bit. Yeah. Don't quite know what I was there. Yeah, these tarps, they glare a bit in the sun. I've had them for quite a while now, quite a good few months. I've had him out in all weather, so I was hoping he'll dull off a bit, but he's still quite shiny on the sun. He's getting tired there. Hide it, it's solid. Put your song on that. So, looks like there's the hammock in it. He is low. But he's low for a reason, so I can look out there. I just want to add, the hammock I normally use is a DD3x3 Coyote Brown. So it's a lot bigger and it covers the DD frontline hammock, which I use in there. So, but it does the job. So it just about covers the hammock. But it was caught out in bad weather. Then that will keep you dry, no doubt about it. So that's my gear in there. It's my 45-litre Sibiu Sock Day Pack. I have got side pouches, and I've got one here, which I am put on. The other one's at the house. Plus, I got like a bum bag, like a snug pack bum bag, which attaches to it as well. So a nice bit of kit. So you can see, just burning away slowly. Takes a while to get going. I'm in no rush. I'm in no rush to leave this place. Packing it, guys. As you can hear, the farmer is on his quad. So it needs a cat rope. All I got in this hammock is a foil mat, which looks just fine. Be able to sound the tube a bit louder. The time is 4:45. So another hour and a half. Things will start picking it up. I've got all what I need just beside me. I've got the stove on. Having a treat. I start rocking, I can put it back on. There you go. A bit of tucker. No white sauce. I'll just have him. Let's heat him up. And I'll go get the coffees out of the bag, which that's where the bag is. On the bungee. Easy access. Off the ground. I haven't bought too many pellets in this burner. So. Going a good. So that's what I was saying, lads, the trip to Scotland I am looking forward to. I'm also looking forward to, hopefully it will happen, meeting Mo and Jill. So that'll be cool. Very nice. We'd like to meet them both, have a camp out. That'd be good. Oh, it's boiling, let me drink. There he goes. Happy day. The only problem now, they've got a flame on the handle. It's not so clever. Right guys, the old supreme chicken is boiling away. I had this flame burn out because I just wanted the heat of the hot embers just slowly heat it through. Temperature's dropping a little now. Time is 5 o'clock. Scott tell me and relax it. Spring is on his way. Okay then guys, give one last look around before as we approach golden hour. So this is the area I'm going to be looking into. So there's no wind now, it's just still, which is good. So hopefully something will be passing down through, coming this way, down there, down in the valley, into the fields. So, hopefully, we'll spot something. That's where I'm at down there. If we look ground level, it's pretty good. Right. Oh, I don't know. Head back down. Into the hammock, just let everything just settle down again. As I said earlier, the dog's not going to be an issue because they're used to it now. Wildlife is around you. So so crunchy, so crispy the ground. The ground is quite damp, but the twigs and all are dry. wrong place to be rambling around. I've had my scarf, I've had my coffee, packed it all away. I don't want to be doing that at nightfall. The only thing I want to be doing is dropping the tarp and the hammock. And get a flag out here. Leave it to the... give it back to the wildlife. See the pack. So we're ready to go. Dogs barking, the farmer calling his sheep, got the pigeons. Let's have a look this side. Now the sun's gone down, it and it's not hitting the tarp and making it shine. So right, I'm getting the hammock now, settle down. I'll bring it back if I see anything. I'm creating too much noise and shadow. A lot of shadows now, the sun's going down, so I bring back the guy. Didn't see the fox I wanted to see, but I've seen a couple of squirrels, heard an owl or two, a couple of owls. Well, so oh, I had a bit of a funny moment where a bird landed on a hammock, my hammock on the side, so scared shit out of me. But just proved I was well hidden, camouflaged, stealth. So yeah, if a bird comes to land on you, then you know you're doing good. So that was a bit of a funny moment. So I got about 45 minute hike back home. So okay then guys, I'll finish off now, and thanks for watching, and take care. Lone Wolf Outdoors. You're real.